Hello?
Hello.
Hi, I'm trying to reach a Mr. Cotton.
This Mr. Cotton.
Okay, can you turn your radio or TV down? I can't really hear you.
Oh, yes, sir.
My name is Mr. Lanson. I'm actually the new principal here at middle school.
And what's the name again?
Mr. Lanson.
Mr. Lanson, okay.
Your son, he attends middle school here, am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Listen, I'm the new principal here. We've just replaced the last principal, and I'm actually calling around. What I've done is before I got here, I asked for a list of students that were, you know, I'm not going to say problem kids, but, you know, that kind of get themselves in a little trouble here and there, and your son's name happens to be on the list.
Name is on that list?
Yes, I got about 35 kids that are actually on this list, and your son is actually on the list, and you are Mr. Cotton, correct?
I am Mr. Cotton. I mean, are you sure you speaking about my son, though?
Yeah. I mean, there's only one on the list, sir. I'm, and it's what's been given to me, and what I'm doing is calling around to all of the parents of the kids that are on this list, and letting you guys know that I'm going to be keeping a close eye on them, as well as letting you know that I'm going to be reinstating corporal punishment here in the school. So
corporal punishment. What's that?
That's actually where if your son gets sent to the office, which is my office, then there will be paddling going on, and opposed to I don't believe in detention. I don't believe in suspension. I believe in, you know, if we spank these kids, we can get them back in order. So
you going to spank him,
sir? Here's my thing. I really truly believe that if we get back to you know, and I don't mean what I'm about to say to be harsh, but if we get back to beating, we'll get these kids back in order.
I mean, but I know he had trouble in English, but I don't think that calls for a beating, for a low grade.
No. This has nothing to do with grades, sir. This has to do with punishment. And what I'm understanding is if your son is on my list, and if your son comes down to my office, I'm going to take care of it right then and there.
I tell you what, if my son comes to your office, you're going to be on my damn list.
Sir, I'm trying to get these kids back in order. And that's the reason why I've been brought in and I've replaced the last principal. You understand? So what I need from you is to get a great understanding that if your child comes to my office, corporal punishment will be what he's going to deal with.
I tell you what. Let my son come home and tell me he got some damn corporal punishment, and the next morning, me and you going to do some corporal punishment.
Sir, do you want your child in order, or do you want to be bailing his butt out of jail at the age of 18?
They're going to be bailing me out of jail if you put your damn hands on my son.
Okay, are you taking care of your son punishment-wise at home?
You need to... My son don't get in no damn trouble.
Here's the problem. Parents not believing that their children get in any trouble. That's the first problem.
Well, then, I got email, I got phone call. So the first phone call I get is going straight to whipping. It ain't no letter sent home, ain't no email sent home saying there is a problem.
I'm going to calm down here. I'm going to tell you once again, I am not going to send your son to detention. I'm not going to call you. I'm going to take care of my job. My job is to make sure.
I'm going to take care of mine. When you take care of yours, I'm going to take care of mine. And that's protect my son. And you put your hands on him, and we got a problem.
Oh, we're going to have a problem because I'm telling you right now, I'm calling you and giving you the warning. Your son will be dealt with.
And you're going to be dealt with.
Will be dealt with on a regular basis if need be.
You're going to get dealt with on a regular basis. You're going to get tired of seeing me.
Okay, sir, do I need to actually have corporal punishment with you?
I tell you what, when you bring that corporal punishment to me, you better have the police there, because they going to need corporal punishment, they going to need whatever else, they going to need the SWAT team when I get down and you put your hands on my son, I know that.
You know what, sir, maybe the whooping needs to start with you. It has to.
Matter of fact, what time do you go to lunch? We can do this in front of the cafeteria and let all the kids see the damn principal get his damn corporal punishment.
Sir, I don't fear you, first of all.
I don't want you to fear me, because I want you to stand there and take your whipping like a man. I don't want to chase you around like no little around the school.
Sir, the bottom line is corporal punishment is being instated. Your son is going to abide by it. You're going to have to accept it, or maybe you need to...
I tell you what, you said you got 35 names on your list? It better be 34, because the Cotton name better not be on no corporal punishment list. I know
sir,
that.
Sir, listen, he's not on a corporal punishment list. He's on a list of kids that act up from time to time.
My damn son don't act up. My son is a model student. He got a little trouble with English. You know, because his mama a little slow, but I did that. You know what I'm saying?
You know what? Sometimes I feel like I'm talking to the child right now.
You talking to a grown man, and if you put your hands on my son, you're going to see that I'm a grown man when I come down there.
Okay.
I'm the only one put my hands on my damn son.
Then I guess it's going to be a lot of kicking, sir.
It's going to be some kicking, and you line them up. Assistant principal, I kick the cafeteria lady. I come down there if she got something to say.
You're gonna watch your tone, you understand me? And you're gonna take what I'm telling you.
I'm a grown man. Who are you yelling at?
I don't care what you're saying. Everybody's gonna abide. I put chains on the door. I make sure.
Oh, no, Joe Clark putting chains on the door. I thought your name was Lansom. You Joe Clark.
I'm Mr. Lansom, and these kids are gonna abide by what I want, and so are the parents. And damn it, you, Mr. Cotton, you're gonna have to toughen up and let me do my damn job.
I tell you what, then you go on and do what you got to do today. But when I get down there, you better have the police when I get there.
I tell you who else I'm gonna have here.
If you tell me who the you gonna have down there then.
I'm gonna have Nephew Tommy from the Steve Harvey Morning Show, because that's who I am. Your co-worker, Silver, you got me to prank phone call you.
What? Boy! Every time, I'm gonna tell you what, I'm gonna break the call you. Next time I catch you. Silly, that's why you ain't get laid on there down at the job. Don't worry about my damn kids, man. Don't be putting your damn hands on my boy. Boy, Tommy. Boy, I was on my way. I was looking for my damn keys when we were talking. I was gonna whip your this morning.
Hey, listen, I got one more thing to ask you, Mr. Cotton.
What's that, man?
What's the baddest radio show in the land?
Man, that Steve Harvey Morning Show. I love y'all, man.